Hi there, it's Brittany from the Checkfront support team. Today I thought I'd make a video to show you how to go about creating a rule specifically for an item or select items. So as an example, I've got an item that I'd like to have a 24-hour cutoff. So booking should not happen if it's within the next 24 hours. Now, keep in mind, this is just one of the rules. You can follow this process for a number of them. For example, you could have a maximum duration per item, minimum quantity. There are a few rules here, but you can follow the directions within this for those as well. So I know that we're going to be using a cutoff rule, and if you can read the description here, it does say units of time follow the item's allocation. So let's have a look at the item and see how it's allocated by going to inventory items. And the item in question today here is the zip line tour. So you can see it's in time slots. So this means that it will, in this rule, be based on hours, not days. Now, this is the default section. We don't want to adjust anything in here because this will adjust all items all the time. We're going to create a new rule and title it something that makes sense to you. So for me, I'm just going to title it zip line cutoff. And then put in place the number of hours that you need, 24. And here you can also decide, is this rule meant for just customers or staff as well? And it's pre-selected to apply to both. So I think that staff are okay to book within that time, so I'm going to deselect that. Great. Now, in order to open up this rule to this item, we have to create an item event as well. So go back into inventory, item events, and create a new one. Inventory status, of course, we want it to remain available. We don't want to close it off. That would be unavailable. Type seasonal. Seasonal is great for working with availability of items as well as pricing. Special is specifically for the pricing. So we're going to go ahead and title it something again that makes sense. And we're not changing any pricing in this case, so that's fine to leave it as the base price. In reoccurrence here, you can decide when do we want this rule to be in place. For my circumstance, I think always is fine, but you can create a one-time event, have it necessary, say for your summer months, or you can have it based on day of the week as well. But we're just gonna stick with always. And you can even go as far as creating the rule for only specific time slots. But we want it to apply to all of them. And here's important, you want to make sure that rule we just created is being applied. So zip line cutoff. Again, another crucial part is to make sure this item event slash rule is applying to the items we wish. So we'll go select none. And we know the category is activity. And we just select the items that are necessary and create. That's great. So now everything's in place, so we can give it a try. First, we'll go into the customer booking page, and I'll show you how the staff booking page looks as well. So here is staff, and we know it was an activity. And for the date, it's not showing up today because that rule is in place. So we can go to the 14th. And you can see here that it does let us book. And it's 6:30 p.m. here right now. So if I did, the reason why it's not letting us do anything on this date or tomorrow's date is because it's past the time. So it has to be booked within the 24 hours in advance. And you get this error that does show the customer that they have to select after that. And same with the date. Today, this is today's date, the 12th. That's tomorrow. And all of these slots are past the time that it is right now, 6:30 p.m. So that's why you cannot book. But it will let you book on the 14th, which is exactly what we want. Now we'll have a look at the staff booking page. So you can go into booking here, activities, And you can see that it is indeed available to be booked for tomorrow if it's done by staff in the Checkfront app. Awesome. So I hope this is helpful for you. But of course, if you have any further questions, feel free to reach out at support@checkfront.com. Hope you have a great day and take care.